Dears, next topic, rheumatoid arthritis. Important one. Let's talk about RA. Rheumatoid arthritis. Again, autoimmune disorder. You have to know here. It's mainly seen in, again, females, more than males, more than 45 years old. People, you can see this. The main thing you are going to see is pannus formation in the joint. Pannus formation. Or you will have joint space narrowing. Joint space narrowing. Or you will have periosteal erosions. The typical feature here, the patient will have morning stiffness. Pain in the joint mainly at morning, and that will prolong till more than 60 minutes. Remember, if they give you in any exam, morning stiffness only for 30 minutes, more than half an hour, osteoarthritis. More than 60 minutes, rheumatoid. More than 30, osteo. More than 60, more than 1 hour, rheumatoid. Here, joints of hands will be affected, or feet will be affected, more than or three joints. That will be affected symmetrically. Symmetrical joint affection. You can see cholesterol deposition. Cholesterol deposition. In X-ray, you can see like some usura. Usura formation. Mainly remember, you will have affection of PIP, proximal interphalangeal joint. Mainly proximal interphalangeal joint. They spare which joint? DIP. Where is DIP affected? In osteoarthritis. They only affect what? Proximal interphalangeal joint. Or you can remember, there is a node seen there, Bouchard nodes. Heberden nodes for DIP, that is mainly for osteoarthritis. Right. Then, you will see the antibody here in the blood, that is anti-CCP. It will be more better than rheumatoid factor. Always remember which one you will choose, anti-CCP. In some children, you know, young age people, young age, sometimes they will have parvovirus infection, parvovirus B90. They will have features same like rheumatoid. But is it rheumatoid? No. The question, examining person want to confuse us in young people. But this parvovirus, they resolve what? Spontaneously. They go by their own. Right, so you will have CCP more, so that is the best diagnostic thing. ESR will be also what? More inflammation. Right, so that's about what rheumatoid arthritis. Now how you manage it, or you will take an X-ray. In X-ray you will see periosteal erosions and osteopenia. Why they are having this? Because if someone have rheumatoid, they will use prolonged steroid use can cause it. Prolonged steroid use. That's why you are seeing osteopenia. Side effect of steroid. Right? Resorption of what? Bone. Now, how you what treat the rheumatoid arthritis? You will give them NSAID for sure. You can give indomethacin or meroxicam or ibuprofen. Anything. Right? Any. Never give only NSAID. You have to add them disease modifying anti rheumatoid drugs. Like you might have heard about methotrexate, always go with the first choice. Methotrexate or leflunomide. This is the second choice. If this is not effective, only you can give hydroxychloroquine. normally hydroxychloroquine for pregnant women because they can't take what methotrexate, or in the case of mild symptoms you can use without any erosion, no erosion of the bone, or sulfasalazine. Plus or minus you can use what, yeah, like the immune modulators and all, like infliximab or rituximab, etanercept. Make sure if someone using immunomodulators, monoclonal antibody, they got vaccinated, because this can induce what, TB or any other fungal infection, the side effect, they induce this disease. So make sure patient is already vaccinated for what, these diseases, right? So like plus or minus, if they are so severe, add this monoclonal antibodies. And for flare, for sure, if there is flare, acute symptoms, you will add what, steroids. But prolonged use of steroid will cause you a lot of side effects, as I told you, osteopenia and all you can see. Then there is something called Felty syndrome. Felty syndrome, that means someone have rheumatoid arthritis, neutropenia and splenomegaly. That is simply known as a combination. We call it as what? Felty syndrome. Hope I added everything that is really needed for what, exam point of view. Rheumatoid arthritis, right? Yeah, so that's all. So once again, in young people, always suspect parvovirus. Remember, they will cause you fifth disease, parvovirus B90, that is slapped cheek appearance. You can rule out it. It's not rheumatoid. They will have same symptoms, morning stiffness in the joints and all. So in young, rule out it. Still, you can confirm by doing X-ray and what, anti-CCP test. Thank you.